In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's Gospel. It's the 2nd of March, Saturday of the 7th week in ordinary time. The Holy Gospel according to Mark chapter 10 verses 13 to 16. At that time, they were bringing children to Jesus that he might touch them. And the disciples rebuked them. But when Jesus saw it, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of God. Truly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God like a child shall not enter it." And he took them in his arms and blessed them, laying his hands upon them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. "Of such," said Jesus, "is the kingdom of God." Why did Jesus like and value children so much? Perhaps because of some of the chief characteristics of children, such as 1. Humility. Prominence and publicity usually embarrass children. They don't think in terms of place and pride and prestige. They are too young to discover the importance of themselves. 2. Obedience. Apparently, it seems that children are often disobedient, but their natural instinct is to obey. They are very dependent on others. They don't know how to separate man from his fellow beings and from God. 3. Simplicity. They make no claims to power and status. They are very simple and straightforward. 4. Trust. This is seen in their acceptance of authority and by the confidence and trust they have in other people. They simply place their trust in their parents and elders. 5. Short memory. They don't bear grudges and nourish bitterness. When treated unjustly, they forget easily and so completely that they don't even need to forgive. When treated unjustly, they forget easily and so completely that they don't even need to forgive. So, 5 chief characteristics of children: humility, obedience, simplicity, trust, and short memory. The Lord reminds us that indeed of such is the kingdom of God. If anyone wants to be part of the kingdom of God, one ought to be like a child. That is, have the attitudes and mindset of a child. All of us should cultivate and maintain those qualities of a child if we want to enter the kingdom. Secondly, adults should show compassion and kindness to all children, lay hands on them and bless them. Thirdly, protect children from child labor, sexual abuse and exploitation, illiteracy that deprive their childhood of joy and delight. Let us ourselves strive first to be like little children and then create an ambience of the kingdom of God here on earth itself. Let us pray. My dear friends, as we find in the Bible diary today, Iril Ritesh Minesas from Katipalla, Lidwin Minesas from Permude, and Gracie Barbosa from Muscat are celebrating their birthdays. We wish them happy birthday and we pray God's choicest blessings on them. Today, as we honor our Heavenly Mother, let's pray the novena prayer to Our Lady of Mount Carmel, asking her intercession for all our children who are writing as well as preparing for the exams, peace in our neighborhood, especially between India and Pakistan, and also for the upcoming parliamentary election. And also we remember all those brothers and sisters of ours who have sent their special prayer requests. Holy Mother of God, we greet you as Queen and Mother of Carmel. You were raised from being a lowly handmaid to the great dignity of Mother of the Word Incarnate. We dedicate ourselves as an act of filial homage. We glorify the Holy Trinity by honoring you, and in our many needs we have recourse to your protection and your powerful intercession. Jesus, your Son, was so obedient to you on earth, will certainly grant your petitions on our behalf. With this trust and unbounded confidence, we beseech you to hear our prayers and obtain for us of your divine Son the favors we request in this novena. Having experienced the efficacy of your prayers, we are full of confidence that you will gain for us this favor if it is for the glory of God and for our good. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our Lady of Mount Carmel, pray for us. Thanksgiving prayer. Holy Mother of God and Queen of Carmel, we, your children, come before you in a spirit of filial devotion and gratitude. As Mother of our spiritual life, You have obtained for us innumerable graces and blessings from our Heavenly Father, who has given to us through you the greatest of all treasures, Christ our Lord. We recognize with deep sentiments of thankfulness all the spiritual favors that have come to us through your powerful intercession. In particular, we thank you for your special protection over those who wear your holy scapular with faith and love. And finally, we thank you for answering our prayers in our personal needs. We implore from you the great grace of final perseverance, that we remain faithful to the end to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Pray for God's blessing, my dear friends. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest, and my WhatsApp number is 94812-63229. 94812-63229. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.